Hello, everyone. Good morning.
Hi, teacher. Good morning. Good morning.
Hello, Fer. Hello, Melissa. Jessica, good morning. Alondra. Hope you guys are doing well. Everyone else looks like we've got, let's see here. Okay, about 16. Alessandro, good morning. Belen, Fernanda, Caro, good morning, everyone. Trying to get my camera going for some reason, doesn't want to work, so I may have to look at that a little bit later. Feel free, guys, if you do not have a lot of background noise, to keep your microphones on. Feel free to jump in. Of course, with your microphone or post messages in the chat as we go through this course this week. And today I want to begin by giving you just a broad overview of what my intention is with this course. I want to try, excuse me, I want to try to adapt it as much as possible to the information that you're sharing in your in the questionnaire. So let me share my screen and give you a general overview of the class and kind of orient you into the Teams space that we'll be using for this course. All right, so the course is called TOEFL English Practice Course. I really had a hard time trying to come up with a good title for this. But I think TOEFL preparation or practice or English practice, yeah, more or less includes what the general objective of this course is going to be. It's scheduled for 10 hours. And when I say 10 hours, I will be scheduling online sessions throughout this week, Monday through Friday, and probably totaling around 10 hours. Now, that could vary. It's going to depend on really what kind of online sessions you need. And so for right now, if you go into Calendar in Microsoft Teams, you'll see that I've scheduled 2-hour sessions Monday through Friday, starting at 10 in the morning and ending at noon, 12 o'clock noon. Now, this could change depending on what kind of input I'm getting from all of you. And if there's anyone that is not able to meet at all during this session from 10 in the morning until 12, let me know. All right, I have no problem scheduling some sessions in the evening if this schedule doesn't accommodate all of you. Right, so at least you'll be able to participate in some of the online sessions. So I encourage all of you to attend as many of the online sessions as possible. I'm going to try to offer a variety of different types of practice and strategies that relate to different aspects of the TOEFL exam. But yeah, try to attend as many online sessions as possible. There's not a requirement. As far as your attendance goes, but I'm going to take attendance each day that I have an online session. All right. So it's important that we together have some kind of evidence of participating in this course. And part of that evidence, part of that will be our participation in our online sessions, of course, and then any other files and activities that we do, mainly as it is all kept within Microsoft Teams. Okay, so this is the schedule. If there are changes, I would refer to this calendar. Okay, so if, for example, if I decide on Thursday to move the session 1 hour before, I'll make that change here in this calendar. So all of you should be able to have access to those changes. Okay. So this is our calendar, and the calendar again will have all the information here in terms of when we're going to meet. But for right now, I'm going to where we basically have sessions scheduled from 10 in the morning until 12, Monday through Friday. Okay, but again, that could change. All right, so let's go back to the main page. Of course, our posts here, I encourage all of you to post new conversations here, posing questions, things that you want to look at, maybe questions that you have. Feel free to use this public space, especially if you think that your question will be helpful to any of your classmates, okay, or any of your classmates in other semesters. As you know, this course is open to all BA students, so we're going to have a variety of students from different semesters, and that's the intention. But feel free to post your questions publicly so that we can all, you know, gather information from your question and suggestions that I post here. You'll notice on the left-hand side, currently, we have two channels, a general channel, which is the channel that you're seeing here, and also one for writing and research. Now, I've decided to create a channel for writing and research because there are just a few, based on the survey, there are just a few of you that have an interest in writing and research. And so I created a separate channel for that space, for those questions that relate to research and or writing. I would also throw in questions related to APA, that feel free to use this space for those types of questions. Okay, again, academic writing, APA, formatting, and overall general research questions. And I'm thinking specifically for those of you who are in seventh semester, going into eighth semester, thinking about your thesis, thinking about your literature review that you already developed in seventh semester. Now, at this point, we'll keep the channels as they are here, two general channels, or one for the general and another for writing and research. If later we decide we need another channel, perhaps we'll do that. Okay. All right. We have a files section. We'll talk a little bit more later today about that. So if you're familiar with Teams, you know that there's a files section. This is where the folders and files for the course will reside. We have a OneNote notebook here, which we'll be using later. It's a little slow to open. And there's a website. And the website here is a public website that I'll also be keeping information related to what we do. All right. Again, later as we get into the grammar section, I'll be speaking more about this space. Okay. But just so you know that this is going to be a public space and you can obviously access this, it will complement what we do throughout the course. Now, before I forget, I will try to record all of the sessions for the course. And when we finish today's recording, you should see a folder here called Recordings under Files, where you should be able to access any recordings that we have for the course. Okay, so if you need to go back and review anything that we talked about, or if you are not able to attend an online session and you want to go back and see what you missed, this is where you can do that. I also intend to make some of our sessions public. This is for my own purpose, in the sense that a lot of what I do in my own podcasting, I share a lot of information that I do as an instructor. If anyone is not comfortable with me sharing our discussions for this course publicly, that's fine. Please send me a chat in Teams and I will respect your wishes. If you're not comfortable with sharing anything that we talk about and do in the class publicly. Okay. All right. Basically, that's an overview of this space for the course. Again, it begins today. It will run through Friday. It's scheduled for 10 hours. So we'll schedule online sessions for 10 hours throughout the week. Now, if you haven't done so already, I encourage all of you to complete the online questionnaire. This just gives me basic information about the course, about what your intentions are, what semester you're in, what would you like to focus on, your availability, and also just any other additional information that you would like to share with me for this course. Again, my intention is to try to adapt it as best as possible to accommodate what you're after, what you're looking to get out of the course. Now, just so that you know, let me pull up very quickly the results that we have thus far, just to give you an idea of those of you who completed the questionnaire. And you still certainly can do this. I'm, again, encouraging everyone to complete this questionnaire to give me some general information about what you're, what you would like to get out of the course. So far, 37 of you have responded. This is the breakdown in terms of semester from prope to seventh semester. This is the breakdown in what you would like to get out of the course between all of the domains, listening, speaking, reading, and writing. It's pretty well split. We've got a lot of you that are interested in grammar, listening, and writing, it looks like, and TOEFL preparation. Some of this is an overlap. So, of course, grammar. What I had in mind was to focus on grammar and listening and vocabulary, right, as it relates to TOEFL, okay? And writing, again, we can separate that into the other channel if you have some specific questions. For those of you who want to focus on writing, the first thing that I would suggest that you do is share any of your writing that you want for either for me to review, or if you have questions, it a lot of times will help me see what kind of questions you have with some examples of your own writing. So if you have a, if you want me to provide you some feedback, or you if you have specific questions about academic writing and or research, as I mentioned before, this is the space. Okay, so you can post your questions here, and I would upload in a Word document any examples of your writing, again, for me to either look at or comment on, right, depending on what kind of feedback that you want. Okay, so I think that would be the best way to handle the writing slash research. I'm kind of throwing those into the same category, right? Even if you're writing just a 5-paragraph essay, a lot of what we talk about or what I'll suggest will also apply to those of you who are thinking about writing a longer thesis paper. All right, so this is more or less the breakdown. And let's see here, the availability. Okay, so again, most of you are available kind of in the morning until 12. Okay, so again, this is the reasoning why I scheduled it from 10 to 12. But again, if there are a few of you who are just not available at all in the morning and we need to schedule some sessions in the afternoon or evening, that's certainly a possibility. I have no problem doing that. Okay, just to give you guys an idea of the information here, it's regarding the course. And let's get into our first activity here for today. So today's session will run through we started at 10, of course, we'll go until 12. And I want to spend the next 40 minutes or so doing kind of an activity related to vocabulary. And then at 11, I have planned an online, basically an online form that will also provide some additional practice for vocabulary. But for today, I'd like to focus primarily on vocabulary. And I want to start by looking at a file in Microsoft Teams. If you're on a computer, this is probably going to be a little easier if you're on either a laptop or a desktop computer to do this activity. You can do this on a cell phone if you have an Excel app installed on your phone. All right, so the first thing here is I'm going to open this up in Microsoft Teams. We have an Excel spreadsheet that you should be able to open up on your computer if you would like to do that at this time. And what I'd like for you to do first, before we start to look and discuss these vocabulary words that I have listed here in the Excel spreadsheet, I'd like for you to, without looking them up, okay, a lot of things that we're going to be doing in this class, I'm going to ask you to follow a certain type of approach to doing this. So without looking any of these words up, do the best that you can to try to insert synonyms. Now, notice that I have several columns. It really doesn't matter where you put the synonym, okay? But if you feel you know the meaning of the word without looking it up, try to find a synonym for as many of the words as possible. Also, we have antonyms. Antonyms are going to be the opposite. If you know the meaning of the word, and you can also find an opposite, an antonym of that word, then you can add that here as well. So I'm going to give you guys a few minutes here. Again, try to do this as best you can without looking up the word. This is just to give us kind of an idea about where we are as a group in terms of our current knowledge of any of these words that are listed here. If you don't know the word, don't worry about it. At this point, I'm going to ask that you not look up the word in the dictionary. Okay, we'll be using the dictionary this week and today, later today, for some of these words. Right now, we just want to get an idea about certain words that we know or that we think we know. Okay, you can make your best guess. Try to find a word that's similar, that has the same meaning. And feel free to add these synonyms or antonyms to this spreadsheet. I'll give you a few minutes. I'll go ahead and mute my mic. Jump in if you have any questions at this point.
Okay, looks like we've got a good amount of synonyms here that we've included in some of the words in the A column. The words under where it says word in context, okay, in A column, these are going to be some words we're going to look at, and I'm going to provide some examples. Some example sentences using some of these words. So I'm going to open up the chat if you want to go ahead and take a look at the chat. And let's start with the first word, dedicated. And I'm going to provide an example. I'm going to type it into the chat. Okay, take a look at the sentence. See how the word is used in the sentence. And in the chat, type in any synonyms that you think apply to this word. Now, it could be synonyms that are included in the Excel spreadsheet. It could be other synonyms. Now that you see the word in the sentence, are there any other synonyms or synonyms even that we included here in the Excel spreadsheet that would apply to this particular example? Feel free to type in any synonyms that you think apply, any words that you could replace dedicated in this example. Feel free to type it into the chat. There are no wrong answers. Don't worry about whether you're correct or not. Just type in as many synonyms, any word that you could replace, and try to keep it to one word, any word that you could substitute dedicated for. So you could say Paul is very focused to his mother. Paul is very attentive to his mother. Paul is very caring to his mother, helpful to his mother, careful to his mother. All right. Now I'm going to provide you four words, and you tell me which word would be the best option as a synonym. What do you think? Polite? I'm sorry, this should be devoted. Agreeable or considerable? Which of these words do you think is the best synonym? Polite, devoted, there should be a D at the end, devoted, past tense, agreeable, or D, considerable? What do you think? And you can type it into the chat. Which of these would be the best option? Okay, we've got two votes for devoted, three votes for devoted. Yes. Devoted probably is going to be the best answer. Now notice that these other options, polite, grammatically speaking, right, they do fit, okay? That you could, grammatically speaking, you could fit it in there, but as far as the meaning of the word dedicated, when you are dedicated to something, you're devoted to something or someone. If you're dedicated to a person, you could also say, I'm devoted to my family. I'm devoted to my boyfriend or girlfriend or my best friend. So if someone could add the word devoted to our spreadsheet, I think that would be a good thing to do. If anyone wants to add the word devoted to our spreadsheet, let's look at the next example. Okay, so the next example here, I'm going to type into the chat. We're now looking at the word demonstrate. Demonstrate. If you can find a word that has the same meaning as demonstrate, type it into the chat. What do you think? What's a good synonym, a good word that you could replace the word demonstrate? Got show, anyone else? Any other words? Indicates, okay. These can be words that are, it could be included in the Excel spreadsheet that we did earlier, or maybe not. Any other words that come to mind? Any other words that you can substitute for the word demonstrate? Let's look at some options. Of these four options, guess, learn, estimate, and show, which do you think is the best answer? Right, letter D, right? This one, actually, many of you have anticipated the synonym, in this case, show. You are showing something, you're demonstrating something. All right, and it looks like we already have it. In fact, we have it twice in our Excel spreadsheet. Okay, very good. Let's look at the next word. Here's the example. We're looking now at the word inappropriate. Inappropriate. We need to find a synonym for inappropriate for this context, right? In this example. So go ahead and type it into the chat. Incorrect, okay, as we have an option here, incorrect. Any other words that come to mind? Inadequate? Necessary. Any others come to mind? Any other words that you could substitute the word inappropriate? Okay, here are some options. You tell me which of these four, A, B, C, or D, would be the best synonym for the word inappropriate. Unsuitable, unnecessary, inconsistent, inarticulate. What do you think? Okay, it looks like most of us are choosing unsuitable. I like that answer, unsuitable. Unsuitable, something that is inappropriate could be unsuitable. If someone would like to add unsuitable, what's the opposite of unsuitable? That's an easy one. What's the opposite of unsuitable? If someone wants to add a synonym in our Excel spreadsheet next to inappropriate, if you would like to add unsuitable and the antonym. The antonym's an easy one. That's right, suitable. Right, something could be suitable. That means something is appropriate for something, okay? This person is a suitable candidate for the teaching job. Okay, if someone wants to add the word unsuitable, I think that's a good word to add to our Excel spreadsheet, as well as the antonym suitable next to inappropriate. Okay, we want to make sure we try to keep up our Excel spreadsheet. Anyone, any volunteers for adding the word unsuitable to our Excel spreadsheet? All right, great. Thank you, Fernando. All right, let's look at our next example. Now we're going to be looking at the word convincing. Notice the word in context. Can you come up with some synonyms for the word convincing? What do you think? What do you think? A synonym for the word convincing. Convincing. Are you easily convinced? Can you be convinced easily? Credible, persuade, persuasive, okay. Any others? Here are our options, A through D. I think this one will be easy for you. Okay, reliable, right? What do you think? Which of these options, A, B, C, or D, do you think offers the best synonym for the word convincing? Yep, letter A, persuasive. Persuasive, right? So the argument, although understandable, right? Someone could be, it could be understood, but it wasn't very persuasive or convincing. When you're trying to persuade someone, think of your persuasive essay, right? You're trying to persuade someone. You're trying to convince them to either think differently or to take action. Okay, so we have, looks like we've added the word persuasive to our Excel spreadsheet. Excellent. Next example, and now we're looking at the word sufficient. Here's the word in context. Let me know what synonym you could substitute the word sufficient. Enough, okay, complete, enough, got a lot of enoughs, all right, any other, and you can repeat it, just whatever you think, doesn't matter if someone else has said the same thing, so a lot of enoughs, okay, complete, Any other words that come to mind? Here are our four options. Which of these four options do you think is the best for a synonym for the word sufficient? Adequate. Absolutely. Adequate. Adequate. Because the evidence was not adequate. It wasn't sufficient. It wasn't enough. So adequate, that's a good word to add to our Excel spreadsheet next to the word sufficient. So if anyone would like to add the word adequate. Adequate. When something is adequate, it's sufficient. It's just enough, right? It's not overly abundant. It's not lacking. It's sufficient. It's adequate. Very good. Now we need to see the word meek in context. Here's our example sentence. What do you think? What are some synonyms for the word meek? Now, if you're not sure what the word meek means, without looking it up, see if you can see what the word, what it means in context. And just take a guess without even looking it up yet in the dictionary. What word could you substitute the word meek for? What do you think? What do you think? Timid, shy, quiet, introvert. Introvert. For those of you who wrote introvert, is that a, what part of speech is introvert? Is it a noun? Is it a verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, connector? Think of shy and quiet and timid as being adjectives. We could say meek is an adjective. What would be the adjective form of the word introvert? Right, so introvert is a noun. What would be the adjective? If you wanted to use that word to describe a person, that's right, introverted. All right, here are our options. Which option offers the best synonym for the word meek? What do you think? A lot of lonelies. Anybody else? Everybody thinks lonely is the best synonym, the best word that offers a similar meaning or the same meaning. Okay, we have one person selecting D, humble. Humble. In fact, humble is the correct answer. humble. Humble. Are you a humble person? Who do you know that is humble? Humble, modest, right? Who's modest? Even submissive. Okay, those are, it's another possible synonym. Now, in the, if you're opening up your browser, you see here on my screen a very nice way of looking for synonyms and antonyms. And as we're doing this exercise, I'm going to encourage you to not use it at this time. But when you go in, you start to look up some of these words. Check out the freethesaurus.com website, because this also offers a visual, kind of a mind map of different synonyms for certain words. So if you look at the word humble, for example, right, it can mean modest, lowly, ordinary, right? This offers a good way of looking at both synonyms, which are in green, and antonyms, the opposites, in red. Okay, and so this is also a good, I think, a visual way of looking at some of these words here that we're looking at. But again, I'm showing you this as a tool that you can use. For now, let's look at our next example. We're looking at the word fake. So here's the word in context. What do you think? What word could you use as a synonym for the word fake? What do you think? What's a good word, a synonym for the word fake? Unreal, pretend, false. Okay. Any others that come to mind? Any other words that come to mind that would have the same meaning as the word fake? Okay, here are fictitious, okay? Here are some options. Which of these four offers the best synonym? Expensive, stolen, simulated, or sold? One vote for simulated. What do you guys think? All right, got a lot of votes for simulated, and I would agree. Simulated. Think of the word simulation, right? Pilots of airplanes, airplane pilots, will often go through a simulation, big computerized machine that helps them learn how to drive a plane before they actually get into the big airplane to fly. It's a simulation. It's fake, right? It's not real. So this is a good word to add to our Excel spreadsheet. Also, we need to add our synonym for meek. If someone would be so kind to add those synonyms. To our Excel spreadsheet. Simulation, simulated. If you simulate something, you're pretending, you're acting like something that's not real. Okay, if someone could add our synonyms to our Excel spreadsheet. Any volunteers to add our synonyms to meek? That's row 7 and fake, row 8. We've got simulated for fake. And humble for meek. Okay, so we got simulated. Okay, just there we go. Thank you. All right. Next example, now we're looking at the word potential. Here's the word potential used in a sentence. What do you think? What would be a good synonym for the word potential? Probable, possible. Okay, any others? An experienced driver is a possible danger, potential danger. Here are our 4 options. This one's, I think, an easier one. Some of you guessed the response, possible. Okay, so if someone could add possible to our Excel spreadsheet. All right, here's our next word, drifted. Now, without looking this word up, it looks like no one offered a synonym. So now that you see the word in context, what could be a synonym that you could substitute for the word drifted in this example? What do you think? What do you think? Any synonyms that you could use? Moved, okay. Anybody else? Try to pay close attention to the part of speech for the word that we're providing a synonym for so that we use the same part of speech. So for example, drifted, right? The sailboat drifted towards the beach. ask yourself, what part of speech is the word drifted in this case? Now, when you find a word that has the same meaning, make sure that you keep the same part of speech. And in this case, because it's a verb, make sure that we keep it in the same verb tense. Any other ideas? Floated. Floated. Good. Okay. The verb to sink, past tense sank. Participio pasado, sunk, right? Sunk, sink, sank, sunk. Float, floated, floated, that's regular. Okay, any other verbs that come to mind? Here are our options. I think this one will be also one that we guessed. What's the best option? Letter B, floated. Now, very good, floated. So we have a lot of you answering B, floated. When you're looking at these four examples, these are actually taking from examples from the TOEFL. So I want you to also pay very close attention to the distractors. I want you to pay close attention to the answers that are incorrect, so that you also understand the meanings of some of those words. Now, because this is in the chat, okay, you can, you know, if you're not taking notes or making notes to yourself of some of these words that are distractors, always make sure that you write down words that you're not sure about. So if any of these words are new, okay, even if it's a distractor, it's important to understand the meaning of the word so that you can recognize the distractors. Okay, a lot of times to try to find the correct word, we have to first eliminate those options that are incorrect. All right, so we have floated for the word drifted. If someone would be so kind as to add that to our list. All right, let's look at one more. Okay, so we're looking now at the word primarily. Primarily, ask yourself, what part of speech is primarily? And think of a synonym, a word that you could replace this word with. Okay, firstly, any other ideas? Mainly? Anybody else? Okay, got some mainly, principally, okay. Anybody else? All right, here are our four options. Of these four, again, looks like some of you have correctly guessed the word. Here are our options, A, B, C, or D. What do you think? Objectively, mainly, actively, subjectively. Mainly. Primarily, mainly. Absolutely. Looks like we have the word mainly to our list of synonyms for the word primarily. All right, so what I'd like to do now, guys, we'll continue to come back and look at some of these words. I think it's very helpful for us to look at some of the words that you might see in a TOEFL exam. Looking at the word in context, a lot of times we can learn the meaning of the word by looking at an example of the word in a sentence. So hopefully in just the few examples that we saw here today, you can try to distinguish and understand the meaning of the word by looking at the word in context. Okay, this is a very important strategy that probably you're implementing already, but I want you to be really conscious of this strategy in how you can try to get the meaning of the word. And when we're looking at our spreadsheet here, we're going to continue coming back to this, but always try to find words that are synonyms to these words. If any of these words in this list are new to you, again, take a look at this free dictionary website. Click on thesaurus. Type in the word that you're looking for, right? If you want to look for potential. You can see here at a glance, visually, right, some synonyms, potential. Now notice here, possibly, ability, hidden. These are actually different synonyms that have different, slightly different meanings. So pay close attention to that. This is our word that we're looking up. These are three different meanings. Okay, they're synonyms. But just as one word can have a multiple of meanings, right? The same word can have different meanings, right? This is what this is illustrating. So we have synonym here. This is a synonym. This is a different meaning than this. This is a synonym of potential, but a different meaning, and so on. And then we have, as an extension, words that are synonyms to these words. And in this case, there are no antonyms, there are no opposites, but you can see, I think, in the last example, again, just to show you, these red boxes indicate opposites. All right, so what I'd like for us to do now is to get some additional practice. And I'm going to stop sharing my screen at this time, and I'm going to share a link to you. Share a link with you, and let me open that up here, and I'll give you basically the rest of the session to complete this online form. Okay, you should be able to get your answers or your percentage right after having completed the questionnaire. You should receive your score. If not, I will, let me know and I'll make that available. It should show up though automatically. And once you finish, if you guys have questions, again, reach out to me, send me a chat. I will come back. I'm going to mute my mic after I share the link. We'll come back at 12. I'll have just some closing statements to conclude for today. And this is what we'll do for the rest of our session for today. All right, so give me just 1 second and I'll share the link here in the chat. Again, this will be a lot easier if you have a desktop computer, but you should be able to open this link up in a browser on your cell phone to complete the form. Okay, so I'm going to share the link. And if you want to go ahead and begin, if anyone has some issues accessing the link, let me know. All right, and I'm going to go ahead and mute my mic. Jump in, guys, if you have any questions. And we will reconvene to close the class at 12 o'clock noon in about 55 minutes. Sorry about that. All right, guys, it is 12 p.m. and we'll go ahead and close for today. I just want to end with a few comments regarding certain strategies that I would recommend that you consider to help develop your vocabulary. Now, the practice that we did today online, I'll be closing here in a few minutes. I'm going to keep it open only during the time we have online sessions. So for those of you who are just now finishing, I will here momentarily send you a PDF file of your results of your of the vocabulary that you looked at. If for any reason you did not receive your results, let me know. And I'll make sure that you send, I'll send it out to you via the chat in Microsoft Teams. But a few strategies that I would suggest that you consider to help build your vocabulary. The single most important thing that you can do is find opportunities to read text in English. So try to build in, into your daily routine. If it's 5 minutes a day, if it's 10 minutes a day, spend a little bit of time each day reading in English. This, above anything else, will do more than more to help your vocabulary building and also your overall English proficiency level. Right? Again, the best thing you can do is to find text to read in English. Find things you're interested in. Okay, and really try to take advantage of reading a little bit each day, even if it's just a few minutes each day. Right? I would try to avoid reading, for example, just on the weekends or every other day. It really does help if you can spend a few minutes each day to read. Okay, so this is a very important strategy that will certainly help broaden or increase your vocabulary. Other activities that you might consider, you might think of keeping a notebook, making flashcards, keeping certain word lists. There are some important word lists. For example, you can find online like the most used or most common 1,000, 2,000, 4,000, 5,000 words that are used. And that is a good way to begin building your vocabulary, looking for the words that are most often used. Okay, most of the words that we use are within 2,000 to 3,000 words. I would say 80 or 90% of the words that are used in day-to-day conversation are those 2,000 to 3,000, maybe 4,000 words, right, that that we end up using. So this is another way to think about looking at building word lists and considering certain word lists, right? There are a lot of strategies that you can use to broaden your vocabulary. Also, I've included a link here to a corpora. A corpora is simply an online database that you have access to see certain words in context. Okay, we'll be talking more about these strategies throughout the week, but I think at this point it's a good idea to take a look at this page, take a look at some of these strategies. I've also included a link here to 35 of the most common prefixes in English that also will help will help your vocabulary development. All right, so take a look at this. This page that I'm showing here, in fact, I don't think I'm sharing my screen. Sorry about that. But this screen that I am sharing with you now, this is the same page. Okay, this is the same page that you can access in Microsoft Teams in our main page. Okay, so the strategies that I just mentioned, reading, these different activities like keeping a notebook, flashcards, word lists, corpora. Okay, these are some things that you can do. Now, do you have to do all of these? Not necessarily. Find which strategies work best for you to help build your vocabulary. All right, my friends. Tomorrow, at this point, we're going to meet again tomorrow at 10 o'clock in the morning. And we will look at or have some opportunities to practice our listening comprehension. Okay, we'll probably break down the first hour, like listening to certain audio. And I want to bring to your attention, let me open up our Teams here. Let's go to our main page. If you guys go under files, under audio, you will find the audios of our practice for tomorrow. Now, all of you are at different levels in your English language development. So some of you might benefit by not listening to the audio first. And when we get into our practice tomorrow, just listening to it and doing the best you can to answer the questions correctly. Others might be at maybe at a more basic level and feel more comfortable by listening to the audios between now and tomorrow before we begin our class. So I'm going to leave it up to you whether you think you need or would benefit from listening to the audios that we're going to be looking at listening to tomorrow in our online session. These audios, it's in an MP3 file format, and it only includes the audio, so it doesn't include the questions. But if you want to have a listen, all right, be very strategic in how you listen to the audios. Now, what do I mean by that? What I mean by being strategic, what I mean by that is listening to the audio, either taking notes, listening to keywords, technical words, words that you're not sure of. Maybe they're idiomatic expressions. Maybe they're phrasal verbs, okay, that are also idiomatic, that are sometimes difficult to understand. And making a list as you're listening to these audios. Pausing the audio when you need to, repeating the audio as you need to, and listening to the audios as many times as you need to understand the gist, to understand the overall meaning. So you decide, do I listen to it? And if you decide, yes, I would benefit, I want to listen to the audios before tomorrow, then be strategic. Follow those different strategies to listen and be active in your listening, writing out notes as you need to, maybe even writing certain mind maps, certain relationships as you're listening. Maybe the speaker is comparing two things. Maybe the speaker is drawing equivalents, maybe saying certain things are similar, right? You decide if you would benefit from doing that before tomorrow's class, okay? But I'm going to make the audios available for you. Tomorrow, we're going to be working with these audios as well as the questions. I'll give you the last hour, the second hour of tomorrow's online session to go through, I think there are 30 or 40 questions, listening to the audio and answering questions, much like the TOEFL. Okay, and in the first hour, we'll go through and listen to sections of the audio, and we'll be looking for keywords, focusing a lot on phrasal verbs and other idiomatic expressions. All right, guys, this is our plan for tomorrow. Please reach out to me if there's something very specific that you want to discuss or that you want me to look at. I'm also thinking specifically to those of you who are wanting some feedback on your academic writing and or your research. Okay, so I know that those of you who are focusing on research, there are just a few of you, but I don't want to ignore your questions. I want to make sure that we build in a time to address your concerns if that's what you're after. All right, guys, I think we'll stop there for today. Enjoy the rest of your day, and tomorrow we'll start again at 10 o'clock again. Feel free to contact me if there's something that you need that relates to your English proficiency that we're not able to address in our online sessions. All right, guys, thanks. Take care. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
Thank you, Ben.
Thank you, teacher.
Take care.